Hello everyone. Today from Module 3, Highway Materials and Pavement Design part, I will explain about Equivalent Single Wheel Load or ESWL. Let's begin with the introduction. Equivalent Single Wheel Load, in general it is called as ESWL, is a single wheel load of an axle having some contact pressure which produces same value of maximum stress, deflection, tensile stress at the desired depth of the pavement. Before discussing in detail about the topic, let me explain you about the legal axle load or maximum axle load which the vehicles can have. To design a flexible pavement, we must know what is the load which is acting over a pavement structure. IRC, that is Indian Road Congress, gives the maximum load that any vehicle can have at the front axle is 6 tons and at the rear axle is 10.2 tons. If vehicle is carrying load more than this design load, that means it is damaging the pavement. Normally, in heavy commercial vehicles, front axle is provided with single wheel assembly and rear axle is provided with dual wheel assembly. Say, if the pavement is designed for 10 years, suppose overloading is acting over the pavement, then the pavement will not last for 10 years. Its lifespan will reduce. Now talking about ESWL, equivalent single wheel load at any selected depth may be determined by two methods or two criteria. First one is equivalent deflection criteria and second one is equivalent stress criteria. As per deflection criteria, the ESWL produces the same deflection at the selected depth for a wheel load of same contact pressure. So that is for first one, deflection criteria. Now, when we consider stress criteria, the maximum stress at the desired depth depends upon the dual wheel assembly of the vehicle. It can be solved by graphical method. Okay? Right. Here you can see a truck with front single axle and rear single axle. But at the rear end, dual wheels are provided. Now for the analysis of ESWL, we are going to consider one pair of wheels from the axle, so which is marked over there. So that explanation we'll see in the next. Okay. In this figure, a pair of wheels from rear axle is considered for the analysis. Say each wheels are carrying the same load of intensity capital P. The center to center spacing of the wheel is S. And the clear spacing between the face of the tire is small d. So the stress distribution of each wheel load, it is in the form of truncated cone. That means whatever the cone you are placing it upside down, so it will be in that shape. So which makes 45 degree angle with the pavement surface. Okay, when you see the figure, you can see over there. In the figure, you can see up to a depth of d by 2, each wheel which is having a load of capital P acts individually, that means separately it is going to act over there. So that means the effect on the pavement is not P plus P, that is 2P. Okay, but that will be in between P and 2P, that means it is less than the double the wheel or the double the axle load. After D by 2, load starts overlapping, that is the load as well as the stress is going to overlap up to a depth of 2S. After 2S depth, the load or the stress is negligible. So this is the simple concept of ESWL. Okay. The figure in here shows the wheel configuration of heavy vehicles. So in first figure, you can see a single axle. Of course, this is a figure. This figure is a representation of a rear axle. Okay, so whatever the backside axle is there, so it shows that. So in single axle itself, at both ends, two wheels are provided. So it is called as a dual wheel assembly. So likewise, so when you see second figure, okay, in that second figure, so there are two axles are provided at the rear end. So this is provided when the truck is carrying heavy loads and the capacity of the truck is more. So such configuration is called as a dual tandem wheel assembly. So that is called as a tandem wheel assembly. Okay. So by providing tandem wheel, the distribution of the load at the point of contact reduces. That means if the truck is of more also, it distributes over a more number of points, thus reducing the action of load. Okay, like in this slide, okay, let us see about the graphical method of determination of ESWL. How we can find out the ESWL value for a particular depth. Okay, so by this method, we can find out at a certain depth of pavement how much load or ESWL is acting. So to determine ESWL in the graph, along x-axis pavement depth is considered and along y-axis ESWL, that is nothing but load, is considered. So both are considered in log scale. Okay, so two points A and B are plotted in the graph with coordinates of A being P, D by 2 and B being 2P, 2S. Then the obtained two points are joined with a straight line. Now AB is considered as a locus point where any single wheel load is equivalent to a certain set of dual wheels. Okay, why it is important? So whenever we are designing a pavement thickness, it is advised to check the ESWL at a assumed depth of pavement thickness. So why? Because if the value of ESWL exceeds at that assumed depth, then the thickness can be changed accordingly. So that is the main purpose of doing this ESWL evaluation. Okay. Right. Thank you.